Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creative Process. Today we're gonna work on some amazing abstract design using 3D extrusion that map option in Adobe Photoshop. We're gonna use some tools which are very simple to use, like we're gonna use liquify option to like mix the color combinations, and then we're gonna use 3D that map to give some contrasting abstract design. And now let's look at the last design, and the last design is exactly the same. The steps are similar, exactly the same process, but the uniqueness of that look is so good. So using this technique, using these tools, using these shortcuts, you can create some amazing abstract arts, and that's like completely depends on your imagination. You can create anything. So let's create this. So this I have created first, then I have used this different color tone and created this. So you can use any image. So for this, let's choose an image. Now let's bring in our fourth image, and this is the image I'm going to use for this design. Let's go in there, very simple, filter, liquify. This one is also, we're gonna use liquify. Liquify is totally useful. So I'll just scale down the size and just try to like blend all the colors very interestingly. Just move around and just rotate, zigzag, up and down, side, every angle you can move, you can just click and move around in this region. Left, right, top, bottom, and then circle, anti-clockwise, clockwise. So just keep on doing it. Okay, and after that, let's see, let's bring in the corners inward. So I'll just bring everything inside. So as you can see, I have increased the density to 100% just to move everything inside, something like this. And now let's set it to 15 and again start like go in there and just start blending the colors, something like this, very simple. Okay, this one just so. Okay, and even you can add your own color to this design. Let's say you want to add some different color tones, so I'll just click OK now and use the brush tool, right? So let's convert this into rasterized layer. Now using the brush tool, right, soft brush, okay, choose a color. So let's choose some interesting color. So let's say red. I'll just apply red here. Then I'll choose something different, blue. Okay, so I'll choose blue here. Then let's say you want some dark blue, so I'll just add dark blue over here. So this one, that's, let's say green, so I'll just add green, light green. Then orange, okay, and I'll say orange. So here I have added some interesting colors. Let's try to add more colors just to fill up this region. And now I'll go to filter, liquify, and just try to blend all these colors again using that same combination. So here you can see the color combination is totally decided by you. You can use any wallpaper, but you can add color tone according to your needs. So just keep on adding it. Just blend it properly. Okay, so just keep on adding, it will give you that interesting look. So I'm gonna use this like density tool and try to recreate that shape. So it's totally something like this. So you're just trying to recreate that shapes. Just bring in there, just make it a little bit broader on top. Just bring this up here somewhere. See, I'm just trying to give some interesting like effect by adjusting the colors, blending them together, and trying to like get a interesting look. Okay, let's say you are happy with this. Okay, I'll just click OK and let's compare with our design. So I'll just bring in there. Okay, so here it's the look. Here also, this is something like that, and here it's a little boring. Let's try it out a little bit more. Density around 55, just move it around. Okay, so it's like randomness, giving some randomness look to your design. Okay, okay, and I think it's looking great. Now let's apply that effect. So go to 3D, that map to plane, right? Click OK, and here it is, right? Now for this, we're gonna keep this exact same color. So we're going to give this texture, but only thing we're going to do is to reduce the depth. So click on there, go to Z axis and just reduce the depth value. So just keep it a little bit, something like this. Okay. And then keep on rotating it until you're satisfied with the look. So I'm going to give it something. Let's zoom it out. Set it something like this, or maybe a little bit of this. Yep. Okay. Let's zoom it in. And just place it somewhere around here. Zoom it in a little bit. And that's how. Now I'll just go in there here. And here it is. And let's add a like white background, alt backspace. Maybe let's choose white, alt backspace, right? And here you can see there's a drop shadow effect. And you can easily remove that by adding that white background. Before applying 3D like that map, you can apply the white background and then blend them together and then apply 3D. And that way you can remove that this drop shadow effect. But I have applied 3D that map directly to that artwork I have created. So we got that drop shadow effect as well. And if you want to keep it, it's interesting, you can keep it. But if you want to remove it, that's the first step you'll follow. And then you'll not get that 3D. And let's say you want to do some more adjustments. Let's say you try it out under textures and it's boring, so we'll keep it solid only. Now just selecting that, move around. Okay, I'll just convert this to rasterize layer. Okay, and now let's do some little bit of adjustments. We'll go to camera filter. Okay, camera raw filter, and let's soften this. So I'm gonna soften it a little bit, go here and add luminance to this, zoom it in. Okay, so it will soften the details. Let's soften it, contrast a little bit, soften this. Okay, and I think this is looking great. Click okay. It's softened now. Let's apply a mask. Okay, and just control Z, command thumbnail, apply mask, and go in there and just like soften the radius a little bit inward, smooth it. And feather it a little bit. Or maybe you can just shift the edge inward. So there are totally different ways to make it. And I'll just click OK. So the edges are now a little bit softer. And if you see over here, OK. And now convert into smart object and rasterize the layer. Rasterize this layer. And let's add a little bit of contrast. So image adjustment, curve adjustment layers, right? A little bit of contrast to it, little bit of color contrast. Okay, so a little bit of okay. And now we'll go to our filter, stylize oil painting, and here you can decide how much details you want to give. So stylization, so I'm going to give some smooth ones. And you can reduce the cleanliness here, like you want to give it rough or very smooth. So I'm going to give it in the middle. And this is the scaling value. So how much scale you want to give. So I'll just keep it around 3 and I then click OK. And here we go. We got that nice, interesting looking design here, similar to this. As you can see, you can get the details. You can do that by adding some contrast, image contrast. So I'll go to levels and you can just play around with these values. Okay, so adding that darkness and right, and I think this looks great. Now let's bring in that text. So now I'm going to add these texts. So select these texts and just place and drag and drop it there. Okay, I'll just scale it down and just set it according to our artwork area. So place it somewhere around here and around here. Okay, and enter. And for the background, we're gonna choose yellow. So I'll just pick this color. Okay, and alt backspace, right? And for the last one, we're gonna give this rectangle, and it's very simple. We have used the same rectangular tools, so you can just draw it out. Select the rectangle tool and draw the rectangle, right? You can just scale it down just to make it a little bit smaller. Okay, and longer, and a little bit of like this. Remove the fill color and add black color for the strokes. So just choose black and thickness, increase the thickness around 2. Okay, here it's less thinner. So let's reduce the thickness. So I'm going to select that again, rectangle, and selecting that rectangle tool, and let's reduce it to 1.5 points, right? And I'll try to increase this artwork. So let's convert this to a smart object and just try to scale it up a little bit. Just trying to fill in up the region. Okay, and enter. And I think this is what I was looking for. You can do some little bit of corrections, like adding a mask and using the brush tool and just hiding out this unwanted area which you feel like you don't want to show it to a design. So just go in there and just soften this edges using your masks. Okay, so right, and you can leave it as well, but if you want to clean it up, you can. Here I have used that masking option and cleaned up the edges, so you can do it here as well. But I think leaving it is also looking great. So that's how I have created this abstract cover design using the 3D extrusion depth map option. So in this process, we have created some amazing designs. The fourth one is this. I have created two versions. The techniques are same. The third one was this image where we have used some wallpaper and mixed them using the liquify and then given them some extrusion and then use the curve adjustment layer to give highlight the color combination and added that text. The second design we created was this, where we have created this nice abstract design using the smoke colors and then extruding them and setting an angle. The last design we created was this. So it's the opposite one. We have created, we have extruded it like depth map, and then we have used the opposite direction where it's like concaved and created this design. So it's completely depends on your imagination. The technique is similar. I have used the same concept, same techniques for all the three cover designs, and it comes out amazing. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. I hope you're going to use these techniques and create out some amazing designs of your own. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel.